Power 93.7 WBLK. I'm Yasmin Young. This is the 2 to 6 Takeover, joined by a special guest. The star phone is ringing. She goes by the name of Deborah Joy Winans, and she comes from that legendary family. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So what was it like, or what is it like, growing up and living life, coming from such a famous family?
You know, life was just, it was just life. I think that my parents were very much so focused on making sure we had a semi-normal childhood, and we did. But the biggest thing for us was church. We were in church 2 to 3 times a week, for hours. And we would have to go to the 6 a.m. prayer and the 9 a.m. service and then back at 3 p.m. You know, so we were church babies. And that's the biggest thing, I think, growing up in the Winans household. We were always at church. We would see our cousins there. You know, my uncle is a pastor. And so that was our life growing up. It was church and music.
I was about to say, the music definitely was there, but I read that you only started singing once you played your aunt Cece Winans in the musical Born for This. That's when you actually started singing.
Absolutely. I never wanted to sing. Acting has always been my love and my passion. And so, you know, I told my parents that I was going to major in acting when I got to school. And they were like, wait, what? What do you mean? What are you talking about? Little did they know, it was, you know, growing up, my parents took us to the movies every weekend. We would do double features. We saw everything, probably things we shouldn't have seen. But it created this love and this passion. And I would just look at the screen and say, oh, man, I'm going to do that. And when I got older, it was just as strong as ever. And so I told them I was going to major in theater, and they were like, what are you talking about? And then they saw me in my first show, and they said, oh, yeah, this is what you do.
Right, right.
And they fully supported me. They were 100% behind me, my parents and my brothers. And then I went on to get my MFA from Cal Arts in acting. And I remember my dad saying I had to audition for a musical, but only because I wanted to do the dancing. They were doing this big tango number, and they were only selecting 4 couples. Mm. And I said, oh, my gosh, I have to be a part of this. And I asked my dad to listen to my song, because I had to sing to be considered. And he just said, Joy, that's a shame. I was like, what? Is it bad? And he said, Joy, it's so good. He was like, I said, well, yeah, but, you know, I don't really want to sing. He said, it's not about you. You got to use every gift that God has given you. Mm. And he was like, because it's not for you. It's for them.
Right.
It's for people.
Right.
And that sort of changed and shifted my perspective about what I should and shouldn't do. But acting was always my main pursuit. That was my drive. That was my passion. I didn't know that I would have to record for my very first TV show, but God has really shown me the things that he wants me to do. It's not just about my plan for my life. It's about what he wants to do through me. And so singing, while it was never my passion or my love, is certainly part of what I was put here to do. So, yes.
Absolutely.
It made its way.
and that's a beautiful thing. And that's great fatherly advice, that, you know what, you can affect change in other people by gifting them with what your gift is. So I think that's, you know, just coming off of the heels of Father's Day, that's great advice that he gave you. So let's dive in now. It's the final season of Greenleaf, and it premieres tonight.
Yeah.
And of course, Oprah Winfrey is behind this NAACP award winning series. Talk about what we can expect in this final series.
So this final season, airing tonight on OWN at 9 p.m. Oh my goodness, I can't believe we made it to the final season. It is going to be a reckoning. It is going to be the Greenleafs seeing themselves the way they're supposed to be seen. They will find their way. I think for Charity in particular, the character that I play, you know, the last time you saw her, she had betrayed her entire family Then she was dumped and betrayed by the man that she betrayed her family for. And now she's got a, you know, she got the positions that she wanted. She's AP. But at what cost?
Right.
She's living with the people that she's hurt so deeply, and she's working with the man that has hurt her so deeply. And so she's got to find a way to reconcile that. She's got to find a way to make it right, because at the end of the day, she does love her family and she does love God. She's only wanted to be AP to share her testimony, to talk to women that may need to understand that she is someone that has been where they are, which I think is so powerful, but you did it the wrong way. And so now she's got to figure out how to make that right. And she's also, what I think that you'll see, she's not going to be a pushover. She is not going to be held hostage to the mistakes that she made. She's going to move forward and figure out how to make things right. But she's also not going to let you just shame her.
Right.
She's not into that. And particularly with Phil, she's not going to let him push her over. She's not going to let him win. And I think that's the fight that I really love Charity for.
Well, we are looking forward to it. The final season of Greenleaf premieres tonight, 9 p.m. on OWN. And you can definitely check out more details on our website, WBLK.com. Deborah, thank you so much for joining us and just sharing with us what we can expect from this final season.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me. I appreciate the support and the love. You know, we need this now more than ever, just to support each other. And so we are so very grateful for you, Yasmin. Thank you so much.